Football, let's go to athletics, where Elijah Manangoi and Hellen Obiri are this year's male and female athletes of the year. The two, who had an amazing season, were awarded during the Athletics Kenya Golden Gala in Nairobi.
Having had a wonderful performance this year, winning 7 out of 13 races, including the 1500 meters world title in London, Elijah Manangoi bagged the male athlete of the year award. Manangoi beat strong opponents, including world marathon champion Geoffrey Kirui and 3,000 meters steeplechase champion Conseslus Kipruto.
We are so many athletes, very strong and good runners this season. So I didn't expect that much, but I know myself that all of this season I run well. So maybe I can, I'll be there to fix somewhere.
The female athlete of the year accolade went to another world champion, Hellen Onsando Obiri, who stormed to victory in the 5,000 meters, beating Ethiopia's Almaz Ayana. The Kisii-born athlete, who capped her season with the Diamond League title, also won the Long Distance Athlete of the Year award.
She broke the national 5,000 meters record in Rome in June, setting a new time of 14 minutes, 18.37 seconds.
I'm looking at 2018 season. Na ile kitu niko nataka kufanya sasa, nataka kufanya vyema zaidi kuliko 2017. Mungu akinisaidia tutafanya vizuri zaidi.
Leonard Bett and Karen Chebet, who shone in the IAAF World Under 18 Championships in Nairobi, winning the 2,000 meters steeplechase, were named Male and Female Young Athletes of the Year respectively, as fan favorite Mary Mora received the President's Award.
Sasa najifunza kuwa hii ni mwanzo tu, hii nimeanza tu kidogo, na nataka nifanye vizuri na niendelee nifanye hata miaka mingi kama wao.
Ningependa tu kuambia wenzangu ama wenye tumekimbia nao watie bidii kwa mazoezi.
Other winners of the night included women's 1500 meters world champion Faith Chepngetich Kipyegon, Conseslus Kipruto, Geoffrey Kirui, Boston Marathon winner Edna Kiplagat, and world cross country champion Geoffrey Kamoror.
Kwamba sikuwa natarajia kwamba nitakuwa part of this athletes nominee. So nasema asante sana, na hiyo imenipea morale zaidi ili niweze kuendelea tena kwa mwaka wa 2018, nianze season yangu mzuri tena ili niweze niwe mmoja wao tena mwaka huo.
Msimu ujao tunapanga ni rudi nikakimbie Boston Marathon ili niweze kuona kama nitaweza kutetea tachi yangu ambayo niliyoshinda mwaka huu.
Abula Ahmed, KTN Sports.
Well, congratulations to the winner. That is Elijah Manangoi and Obiri. But still on athletics, Emily Chebet emerged the winner in 10,000 meters as the third Athletics Kenya meeting took off at Kenyatta Stadium in Machakos. Chebet clocked a time of 33 minutes, 59.04 seconds on her way to victory. The 19-year-old was a cut above her opponents as she took the lead with 12 laps to go and never looked back. Faith Linga finished second place, while Karen Chebet claimed third position. After winning the race, Chebet claimed that her ambition at the moment is making it to the team that will represent Kenya at the Commonwealth Games in Australia.
Doping is a major threat to sports in Kenya. The ministry, through ADAC, is committed to combat this menace. I urge all of you to continue supporting us in the fight against doping. To our athletes, I wish to remind you that you have a responsibility of ensuring that you win fairly and clean. We are here as your brothers, as your sisters, as your federation to support you. Come to us if you see any of this threat. As we celebrate this evening, we all agree that 2017 was a great year for athletics in Kenya. We did exceptionally well in cross-country championships in Uganda, where we bagged several medals. We also made an outstanding performance during the IAAF Championships in London, and we continue to dominate the world in different road races.
Well, that was Ambassador Peter Kaberia talking at the gala, talking about matters to do with doping, but still on athletics. Emily Chabet emerged the winner in 10,000 meters as the third Athletics Kenya meeting took off yesterday at Kenyatta Stadium in Machakos. Chabet clocked a time of 33 minutes, 59.04 seconds on her way to victory. The 19-year-old was a cut above her opponents as she took the lead with 12 laps to go and never looked back. Faith Linga finished second place while Karen Chabet claimed the third position. After winning the race, Chabet claim that ambition at the moment is making it to the team that will represent Kenya at the Commonwealth Games in Australia. In the men's 5,000-meter semi-final, Timothy Cheruiyot qualified for the finals after winning his semi-final.
Kwa mbaya, nilikuwa nakucha kuangalia mwili kaa imerudi. Juu tukianza season, sijakimbia track tena, nilikuwa nakimbia cross country. Nilikuwa namba 9, namba 8. Na leo ninashukuru Mungu, juu nilishinda. Nimeona mwili si mbaya, naweza make cross country na Commonwealth. Na nashukuru tena coach wangu, juu alinipatia advice. Nilikuwa nimeenda out of shape, na nashukuru sana, juu alinipatia training nzuri.
Najiandaa kwa kukimbia Commonwealth Games. Hii ilikuwa mbio yangu ya kwanza ya 1500. Sikuwa nimekimbia 1500 meter. Lakini nimefurahia siku ya leo kwa sababu nimewin.
Let's move to volleyball now, where five KCB volleyball team players who have had exemplary performances this year during various outings were fitted by the team. Doreen Marani, Siwa Christine, Milgren Lutuvula, Salome Wanjala were among those who were rewarded. The event was attended by Kenya Volleyball Federation Technical Director David Lungao and Kenya Pipeline Coach Japheth Munala. Salome Wanjala was KCB's most improved player, while Milgren Luvutula won the Most Valuable Player Award. Doreen Marani was awarded for being the best attacker, as Charlene Maiwa won the Best Blocker Award. KCB finished the season on third position during the KVF playoffs held in Mombasa recently.
To another event where we will have a very special breakfast, each and every one of you in a very special way. We are champions in waiting, Asanteni. Now we want to, I think, position ourselves to how we can reach further. It seems like it is near yet so far. And by us being number one, they will not have lost. You are the ones who will contribute to the national team. You are the ones who contribute to the East African Challenge, to the African Challenge, even at World Cup stage.
Well, congratulations to those players, the KCB players. So let's now move to Kenya Cup, and we have a number of matches lined up this afternoon. Remember, some of the teams in Kenya Cup are unbeaten so far, and they will be seeking to extend their unbeaten run in the championship. So we take a look at the matches that have been lined up in Kenya Cup this afternoon at Mombasa. Mombasa will be hosting Kabras Sugar. Remember, Kabras are unbeaten so far. Tofre Nakuru will be at home against defending Kenya Cup champions KCB. Impala Saracens, who lost last week, will be taking on Nondies. That is at the Impala grounds later this afternoon. Other matches that have been lined up for this afternoon include, we'll be having Black Blood taking on Kenya Harlequins at the RFUA grounds. Then we have Kisi hosting High Flyers, Homeboys at the Gusii Stadium. So those are the matches that have been lined up this afternoon when you talk about Kenya Cup. Who is going Are we going to see a number of teams go, you know, a long way, a number of matches without losing, as we saw KCB do last season before eventually going down? So we're going to see that. We'll have to wait and see. Remember, this afternoon's matches are the last for the year 2017 before taking a break. And then the league will resume in 2018. Now, let's move to football a bit.